throats intend to send this treasure to Richard? You wouldn't dream of keeping it yourselves.
Friends! What shall we do with this treasure? Divide it amongst ourselves?
Hold it for Richard!
It belongs to the king!
Convinced?
I may have been hasty, but why you, a knight, should live here like an animal in the forest, robbing, killing, outlaw?
Are you really interested in learning why I turned outlaw? Or are you afraid of the truth? Or of me, perhaps?
I'm afraid of nothing, least of all of you.
Good. Then come with me. Oh, so you are afraid. Hardly an inspiring sight for such pretty eyes as yours, I'm sure. But these poor devils have all had their homes burnt. Their families beaten and starved to death by your tax gatherers.
Bless you, Robin. We'll never forget you.
Oh, well, thanks, Master. May we be worthy, Robin.
You are, Mother, you are. Have you eaten well, friend?
Yes, thank you, Robin.
Thank you, Master.
I'm sorry to have to show you that. But once these poor people were all happy and contented. Just simple villagers who never harmed a soul. And now, tortured, eyes put out, tongue slit, ears hacked off. They come to me for protection against your Norman friends.
But you've taken Norman lives.
Yes, those that deserved it. Cruel and unjust.
You're a strange man.
Strange? Because I can feel for beaten, helpless people.
No, you're strange because you want to do something about it. You're willing to defy Sir Guy, even Prince John himself, to risk your own life. And one of those men was a Norman.
Norman or Saxon? What's that matter? It's injustice I hate, not the Normans.
But it's lost you your rank, your lands. It's made you a hunted outlaw when you might have lived in comfort and security. What's your reward for all this?
Reward? Just don't understand, Claire.
I'm sorry. I do begin to see. A little now.
You do, then. That's reward enough.
Now that you've robbed us and had your fill of insulting us, we wish to leave. Come, Lady Marion.
My own men will escort my lady. But before you take leave of her, it might be as well if you thanked her for saving your life.
My life?
Do you think you would have left this forest alive if it hadn't been for her presence here? Peter, Harold.
Yes, Master.
Take 6 men and guide our loyal host and his nervous friend to the Nottingham Road.
Up, sir.
But our horses, our clothes.
You return to Nottingham as you are, on foot. This, Sir Guy, will at least be a lesson to you in humility, if not in mercy. The rest of your people will be returned tomorrow.
But the Lady Marion?
You'd best be started before I've a change of mind.
I think we'd better go.
Now, my lady. Friar Tuck, Little John. Take the Lady Marion as far as the Abbey of the Black Canons. Then tomorrow the bishop can give her escort the rest of the way.
Oh, Master, may I go too?
Your permission, my lady? Goodbye, my lady.
Goodbye.